Hey students, I am back with an interesting topic today, that is circular flow of income from the subject macroeconomics. And I'm glad that you're finding the videos helpful. And let us start with the introduction of the topic. We all know that we just love money, receiving money, spending money, buying commodities of our wishes or wants. So how does this money change its hand from one place to the other, or how does this money rotate in the economy is what exactly we're going to study under the topic. An economy consists of major three activities, that is production, distribution and consumption. All the three activities are interdependent on each other. No economy can survive without these activities. So how these activities work or how are they related, we are going to discuss in the further subpart. And the major sectors which are involved in the economy is firms, the ones who make the goods and services, households, the one who consume goods and services, government, the institution which takes care of the needs and requirements of the public or the citizens, and the financial institutions which help in facilitation of money in the economy. Now, as we all know that money does not remain at one place permanently. It keeps on rotating, that it keeps on changing hand. For example, I receive my pocket money, say for rupees 500. Now this 500 is not going to remain with me forever, right? Of course, I will be using it for some or the other requirement. So say I spend 100 rupees for purchasing a book. So when I purchase a book, I receive the commodity and I pay the shopkeeper rupees 100. So here the money is changing its hand from me to that to the shopkeeper. Now here the parties to the receiving and the spending end change. Means when I was given rupees 100, at that time my parents were the one who was spending it and I was the one receiving. But now when I am purchasing the book, I am the one who is spending and the shopkeeper becomes the person who is receiving. So here the 100 rupees is the same, but it is changing from one party to the other. So this is what exactly happens in the economy, that the money keeps on rotating from one person to the other or from one sector to the other. Only the purpose changes. So one may make it as an expense and for other it becomes an income. And according to the definition, the movement of money, income or the revenue across the various sectors in the economy in a circular flow is termed to be a circular flow of money, income. So in simple terms, money moving across the economy for some person as an income and for the other as an expenditure or an expense makes a circular flow or circulation, and therefore it is termed to be a circular flow of money income. And I mentioned there are different sectors such as firms, households, government, financial institutions, but under this chapter we are only going to discuss circular flow in a two sector economy. As you can see in this diagram which depicts two sectors in the economy, that is firms and households, each sector is here performing multiple transactions, that is one receiving the money and on the other hand spending the money. Now how does this happen and how do these contribute in the working of economy? Let us understand in detail. Households generally are termed to be as a source of factors of production, that is land, labor, capital, etc. So these people, they give their savings to these firms in the form of loans, which is done by the financial institutions, and they provide them with the labor, which is essential factor of production. All this is provided to the firms by the households, and in return the firms pay them the wages, dividends, rent, etc. So here the households are providing a service and the firms in return are paying them. That is one hand of the transaction. And if you see, once the factors of production reach the firm, they manufacture goods and services as per the need of the household. That is, now they are providing the goods and services to the household, and the households in return are providing them with the money, that is in the form of consumption expenditure. That is the money we pay to the shopkeepers, or we pay to the distributors or producers and manufacturers. So here we see that the money is rotating. It is not stagnant. It changes from one sector to the other in different forms. And thus this in technical term means circular flow of money income in a two sector economy. There are different models also, like three sector economy, there we include financial institutions also, four sector economy, there we include government also. But this is not there in the topic or in the syllabus as such, so we are not going to cover it. In case if anyone requires it for extra knowledge, can mention it in the comment section. We will come up with a video on circular flow of income of three sector economy model and four sector economy model. Now let us see the difference between stock and flow. So stock is defined as the total quantity measured at a particular point of time, and flow is defined as the total quantity measured over a period of time. So stock is a quantity of goods or service or any other object that we are having with us at one point of time, that is in big quantity. And flow is a part of the stock that is removed as per the need. Let us understand this with a simple example. Say I am a distributor of clothes. Now here I keep my clothes in the warehouse, and at once I calculate the total quantity I have with me. So that quantity is considered to be a stock. Now out of that stock, I may remove 10 pieces, I may remove 50 pieces as per the requirement of the customers in the market or as per the demand in the market. So the quantity that I remove, keep removing at different points of time, is called as flow. So stock is a total quantity which is being measured at one time, and flow is the quantity which is measured over a period of time. It is a supply which is being taken from the stock. And stock is considered to be a static concept, that is already mentioned that it does not fluctuate easily. It is a compilation at one point of time. Whereas flow is a dynamic concept, it depends upon the demand in the market. So if the demand is high, the supply will be high, that is flow will be more. And if the demand is less, then the supply will be less, which means the flow will be less. So the dynamic concept, it depends upon the environment and the demand in the market. So I hope we are very clear with what is the difference between stock and flow. Similarly, let us understand the difference between real flow and money flow. So in a circular flow of income, we see that each sector is providing the other with some form of good or a service, and in return getting money. So each of this transaction takes place in the circular income of money. On one hand, it is a real flow, and on the other hand, it becomes money flow. So when the households provide services to the firms, that is the factor services, that is real flow. And in return, when the firms provide them with factor incomes, that is wages, interest, rent, etc., it becomes money flow. Similarly, when the firms provide the households with goods and services, that becomes real flow. And when the households in return to them pay consumption expenditure, that becomes money flow. So both of them move simultaneously in the circular flow of income. Real flow is also called as physical flow, and money flow is also called as nominal flow. Here we can understand with an example is B sells goods to A. So here B is providing goods to A, and it's a physical product, and that becomes real flow. And in return, A pays to B the money expenditure. So this becomes money flow because income is paid by A to B. And here we conclude the chapter. Thank you so much. And for more such videos, do like, share and subscribe. And I believe that you all love money, so definitely you're going to love this chapter too. Thank you.